Well, I was raised sort of with an attitude of contributing and always leaving a place a little bit better than you found it. I've moved around the country quite a bit, and so I've tried to get involved everywhere I've lived. You know, when we came back to Guelph, which is my hometown, that's one of the things I wanted to do right away. Military life is interesting in that you sort of are placed in communities that aren't of your choosing. You know, you're just put in a place and you have to sort of figure it out once you get there. One of those things that you didn't have time to take your time. If you were going to make the most of your 2 or 3 years in a place, you had to kind of dig in really quickly. So you would get there and immediately sign up for a bunch of things and join things so that you would make friends and feel like you were part of that community. The Japanese students started first. So my daughter came home from school one day and had said, you know, they were looking for families to take in these kids that were coming on an exchange. We decided to give it a try and absolutely loved it. The time flew by. We just fell in love with this kid. He's a dear friend now. We're in touch with him all the time. We were part of a sponsorship group for a Syrian refugee family about a year ago, and we knew that they were coming, but they never give you an exact arrival date, and we had an apartment lined up, but not until a certain date. And then we got the call that they were coming, and there was a 2-week gap between when they would arrive and when we'd have actually a place for them to live. We know what it's like to have people in the house that don't speak the same language. It's amazing how easily you can manage with that. Between Google Translate and stick figure drawings and sign language, you somehow figure it all out. It was a remarkable experience. I'd do it again in a heartbeat. We learned so much about that region and what's going on and why there's been this exodus, and really felt like we've just gained lifelong friends with this family. The family that we had stay with us had they were 2-year-old triplets. So it was impossible for them to go anywhere without help. And so I got to know the kids really, really well because they needed my help just to get them to and from places. We cooked together and we ate our meals together and we had far more in common than not. You know, we've opened our home up because it's hospitality, it's what you do. You let people in, you help people that need help, and you often end up getting way more out of it than you give. You know, I sort of just think of myself as a helper. When there's something that needs to be done, I just help, and I sign up, and I go, and I do what I can do to help. There are a lot of women that is what they do. They're just helpers, so it's a real honor to sort of represent those people in this kind of space.